Good morning, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a blessed and peaceful Sabbath. Shabbat Shalom. Now, today we're going to talk about really three things: respect, disrespect, and offended or being offended. Because people really make a big issue about feeling like they've been disrespected when, in actuality, these are the three words that I believe people need to understand clearly what each one means and have a thorough understanding of how to apply them when they express themselves so they can react accordingly, because people quite often use the disrespect card to justify their behavior and or reactions to something that goes on. So we're going to talk about that so people can get some clarity on what these mean and find out if really any of it's still justified in terms of behavior or reaction to feeling like this has been done to you, because the Father's word has something to say about that also. So with that being said, let's get started with disrespect. Okay, let's jump right in. The word respect means, one, to hold in esteem or honor. For example, someone who cheats, you will not hold them to a position of esteem or honor. You will say, I cannot respect a cheater. Secondly, to show regard or consideration for something, to respect someone's rights, for example. Thirdly, to refrain from intruding upon or interfering with someone's right to privacy, personal privacy. You wouldn't interfere in their privacy. You let them have that. Last but not least, you have to relate or have reference to. For example, if we're talking and I say, well, in respect to the conversation we had the other day. And that's simply, in a nutshell, what the word respect means. And we have to understand this when we're saying that I've been disrespected or feel like I've been disrespected. We have to know what respect means. And then we also have to know what disrespect means. And I'm going to get to that in a second. So I'm not going to say if someone doesn't respect these things that they're being disrespectful. I'm going to do like the Father says. Go with me to Genesis 4, verses 4 and 5. And it reads, it says, and Abel, he also bought of the firstlings of his flock and of the fat thereof. And the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering. But unto Cain and to his offering he had not respect. And Cain was very wroth, and his countenance fell. Cain was upset. He was livid. He was beyond over the top. He was mad. Now, it's interesting, like I said, the Father's word says that the Father had not respect, or he didn't respect Cain's offering. Now, this is a far cry different than saying he was disrespectful to Cain. And we're going to get to disrespect in a minute, because we have to understand what the word disrespect means. So basically, Cain was so ticked off that he did what? He went off. He killed his brother because he felt, as we would say today, disrespected. Now, he may have just been bitter and angry and mad, but today we would say, well, he disrespected me. You know how people do. So he allowed all that to fuel his anger, his bitterness, his envy, his jealousy, and he did what he did. So let's look at this disrespect thing a little closer. And we have to understand that if someone doesn't hold you or something to a position of esteem or honor or behavior or whatever, that does not justify really you being able to get mad and go off and act in a Cain-like manner. So keep that in mind. Now, if someone shows a disregard or consideration for your rights or your privacy or whatever, does that still not justify your right to go off and get mad and do all these things? No, it's the same thing. If someone violates your privacy or your rights, they've done that, but it doesn't justify outrageous negative behavior. There are plenty of ways to take care of things when they are done improperly. anger and bitterness and violence and all that is not the answer. So, according to the definition, these types of things are all forms of not respecting or holding something or someone to a position of esteem or honor. We have to be clear about this in our mind. Like I said, Cain was angry because the father didn't hold his offering to a position of esteem or honor, and he reacted in an aggressive, emotional manner, and his responding behavior has never changed to the day. People still react the same way, all because they feel like they've been disrespected. Now, I also believe that the word disrespect in its usage by people is really used out of context in relation to the word respect. This is why people always say, well, I feel like I've been disrespected, when actually they're making a reference to their understanding of the word respect and saying that the opposite has been done to them. But we're going to get right into what disrespect means now. Disrespect means, one, a lack of respect. Two, it means to regard or treat without respect. So when you say, I've been disrespected, there's some accuracy to that. But here's the caveat, here's the trigger for me in the defining of the word disrespect. It also says discourtesy, rudeness, to regard or treat with contempt or rudeness. So when someone says, he disrespected me, she disrespected me, I feel like I've been disrespected, you're saying that you've been treated discourteously, rude, or you've been treated with a certain amount of contempt or ugliness. If that's true, yes, you've been disrespected. Now, that still doesn't justify outrageous negative behavior. Essentially, disrespect is, in one regard, opposite of respect. But you have to be clear when you're saying you've been disrespected that you're saying that someone was discourteous, rude, mean, or nasty, or full of contempt towards you when they did it. If they just chose to not respect something or a behavior, they just simply chose to not do that. So the father said he had not respect for Cain's offering. Was he disrespecting him? I guess in a sense. But if the father wasn't rude, mean, or nasty toward him, he wasn't disrespectful in the sense of what disrespect means. He just chose not to hold Cain's offering to a position of respect. So that's why I like the way that the word says that he had not respect for Cain's offering. It didn't say that the father was disrespectful to Cain. And this is what we have to be clear about today, people. When you say that I've been disrespected, you disrespected me, you best believe you should be saying that, oh, I was discourteous, rude, mean, nasty, contemptuous towards you, or what have you. You make sure that it's about this, but still, don't let it justify a crazy reaction on your part. Okay, most of the time, when people say that they've been disrespected, they say what? I feel like I've been disrespected. They always say, I feel like he disrespected me. I feel like she disrespected me. I feel like they disrespected me. And they say that to justify a behavior. But more accurately, they should be saying offended, because to be offended is more of an expression of a feeling. Disrespect or respect aren't feelings. They are what they are. So we're going to talk about being offended, because it's a more accurate explanation of what happens to most people who claim to have been disrespected in an attempt to justify what their Cain-like behavior in response to that expression of being disrespected. See, like I said, being offended is a feeling, but it doesn't justify negative behavior either. But it's more accurate to what people are always crying out when they say, oh, I've been disrespected. Now, in defense of the being disrespected, to be treated rudely, contemptuously, discourteously, or to be regarded with some form of contempt is a form of disrespect by definition. It is by definition of the word disrespect. The word respect by definition is not that. So be clear about that. But just because or if someone is not holding you or behavior or something in a place of esteem or honor, they're merely choosing to not do that. So people, when someone chooses to not recognize something you do, say, have, or what have you to that position of esteem or honor or respect, simply put, they're simply choosing to not do that. And don't let it get you all worked up and going off. Move on, because really it's a you problem. Meanness and nastiness and rude treatment and all these things are another animal altogether. But neither do they justify an outrageous cane-like behavior. And with that, we're going to talk about being offended in the next video. Respect is respect. Disrespect is disrespect. But neither justify negative behavior. This is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.